Hello, Grateful. How are you? Now, I hope that you are fine. So, here we meet again in this video to deal with the lessons we are going to see on week 5. Now, for the first session, we continue and try to finish unit module 4. So, nice and tasty. We deal with lesson 4 story and the roundup. So, for the story, you find it on page 50-51 and the roundup on page 54. So first thing, we have the story for page 50-51. The first activity here, it is a warm-up. I would like you to watch the video, The Art of Recycling, and answer these questions. Where is Mbogeni Buthelezi from? Has he been using plastic in his art for a long time? How did he come to use plastics? How does the artist feel? The last question, does he come from a rich family? What about you? Do you recycle at home or at school? Is it important for the environment and why? So after you listen to the experience of Buthelezi, what about you? Tell us, what is your relation to recycling? Do you recycle or you don't care? Then we move to activity 1, page 50. And after activity 1, we do go to the reading activity, activity 2, page 50-51. It is entitled Recycling at the Museum. So first thing, I would like you to pay attention to picture 1. Where are the two boys? And what are they looking at? Then you go through the story very quickly and find the names of the two boys. Then I would like you to play to the recording and read along with it in order to find out what the children are making with the old cartons and boxes. Then you read again and you circle any words presented in activity 1. Then I would like you to pay attention to picture 3. What does the poster say? Do the boys want to take part? And then we have the comprehension activity, that is activity 3, page 51. Then, as a post-reading activity, we have a let's think, bottom of page 51. So you read the questions and you answer them in few sentences. I have given you some lines when you can write the sentences. And finally, we have the workbook activities, exercises on page 49. So activity 1, 2, and 3. Now, let's go to the roundup lesson on page 54. So, we have exercise 1, exercise 2. Now, here for exercise 2, I have given you the listening transcript because I don't have the audio recording. And then we move to the exercises in the workbook, page 52 and 53. So, here we have 5 exercises to do. Now, let's go to class 2. So here, we are going to deal with the last unit, the last module entitled Sports. And lesson 1 is Quiz. You find it in the book on page 55. Now, as a warm-up activity, I would like you to look at the photos and complete the table. So here, we have photos representing different sports. And I would like you to give me the name of each sport, to tell me if it is a team sport with many players or if it is individual, and if it is a team sport, the number of the players in a team. So after you finish to fill in the table, what is the lesson about? So it's quite clear. Then you look at the new vocabulary in activity 1, page 55. And then we move to the quiz, activity 2, page 55. Now when we say quiz, it is a questionnaire. Now, this is a text with many questions, and you have to read the questions and circle or tick the corresponding answers. What is the closer answer to you? And this type of questionnaire gives you information about your personality, about your psychology, something like that. Now, first thing, I would like you to look at the quiz, and I ask you, where can you find this type of text? So where can you find it? Can you find it in the newspaper? Can you find it in a school book? Can you find it in the internet? You see, read the questions and choose the right alternative. So you do the quiz here, and then you play the recording to check your answers. Then we move to the look frame, page 55. Here it deals with the past simple, that is the tense we use to talk about past actions. Now, if you look at this man, we say they watch television every evening. So this is a present simple. They watch every evening, repeated action. But here, they watched television yesterday evening. So this is, so if today is Sunday, we say that they watched television Saturday evening. It is past. So watched here is the past simple. So what do you notice? With all the pronouns, I, we, you, they, he, she, it, we have to add ed at the end of the verb. So the past simple is often ed at the end, essentially with regular verbs. For example, work, worked, clean, cleaned, start, started, stay, stayed, arrive, arrived, dance, danced. So here we have some sentences with examples. Here we have a remark about the spelling. When the verb ends in y, for example, like try, it will be ied, tried, ied, study, ied, copy, ied. Then for stop, we have here to add double p, because if we add e, the consonant will be between two vowels, so we have to make it stronger with double. The same with plan, double N. Then, in grammar, we have always irregular cases, and this is what we have for the past simple. Some of the verbs are irregular. They do not end with ED. So some verbs are irregular, not regular. The past simple is not ED. Here are some important irregular verbs. So, for example, the verb begin, we do not say begin, we say began. Break, broke, bring, brought, build, built, buy, bought, catch, caught, fall, fell, leave, left, sell, sold. So, the problem is that they do not, they are not the same. Each one has in its own form. So, the only solution is to learn them by heart. هنا يلزمكم تحفظوهم معناها ما عندناش حل اخر هنا كل فيرب كيفاش هو يتغير ما فيهمش قاعده الطريقه الوحيده باش نعرفوهم اننا نحفظوهم Okay, then we move to activity 3 on page 55 so follow the example of the girls at the bottom of the page just to practice the past simple Then we move to the workbook exercises on page 55, activity 1, 2, and 3. So here again, we deal with class 3. Here we continue with sports, lesson 2, top stars, you have to find on page 56, 57. Now, for the warm-up activity, I would like you first to look at the new vocabulary you have in activity 1, page 56. I have added some explanations here, some sentences to explain the words. I'm a painter, so this is my occupation, my job. Look, I made this painting of a baseball pitch. So the pitch is where we play baseball, the place, because I want to take part in an art competition. Then we move to the story in activity 2, page 56. So first thing, I would like you to have a look at the pictures in general. What do you think is the man with Karim? Is it his father? Pay attention to the frames and circle the new words of activity one. Then I would like you to circle all the new vocabulary from activity one that you find in the story. Then you play the recording, you read along with it in order to find out who painted the pictures. Then another question, what do Karim and his grandpa talk about? Whose is the award? Where is the award from? And we have to check the comprehension with activity 3, page 57. Now, for the post-reading activity, we look at Luke, page 57. Here, we continue to deal with the past simple, but this time the negative form and how we make questions, ask and answer about past actions. So here, I have given you all the forms of the verbs, how it works when the infinitive, positive, negative, and in a question. Now, what do we notice? If the positive, we have to add ed, or we pay attention to the irregular verbs. When we want to make a negative, we have to use the auxiliary did not, or didn't. I did not play. You didn't watch. He didn't see, for example. And we use the same auxiliary did for the questions, but it comes before the subject. Did I play? Did you watch? Did he see? Did she go? So here, like we use do or does in the present, we have to use did for the past. I don't watch television very often, but I didn't watch television yesterday. Or does she often go away? Did she go away last week? Now, when we use did or didn't, we always use the verb infinitive later. So I watched, but I didn't watch. We have nothing here. They went. Did they go? Go is again infinitive. Now, we be careful here. We have to be careful about the word order when we deal with questions. So it is always did plus subject plus infinitive. So did your sister phone you? But when we have WH words like what, how, or where, it comes first. So what did you do yesterday evening? How did the accident happen? Or where did your parents go for their holidays? Then the short answer, when we answer yes with all the pronouns I, we, you, they, he, she, it, did. And if it is no, we will have didn't, the negative form. Then we move to activity 4, page 57. I have here written the listening transcript because I don't have the audio. Then we have activity 5, page 57. So here you have to tick the table and make sentences about yourselves, about you. And finally, we deal with the workbook, page 56, 57, and we have the 5 exercises to do. So as usual, on Thursday, you will have the correction of all the exercises. Thank you for your attention. I hope that this video will help. See you next week.